oily skin.
Yes, I know. I have makeup on my face from work this morning, but it is only concealer and air spun, but it's like separating on my face right now. But we're gonna do our makeup anyways. Just put it over. I don't wanna wash my face like 3 times before tonight. So I'm going in with Urban Decay Quick Fix. This is the NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation. I love it! And I'm in the shade Santa Fe. My skin has been really dry recently because I'm using my acne medication more frequently. It's been terrible. It really dries my face out. So I decided to get this foundation because I know it's supposed to make your skin look just dewy, really. And although I have naturally oily skin, I feel like this foundation just helps my face look natural with makeup on, fit me. And of course, Tarte Rainforest of the Sea in light. I mean, if you couldn't tell, this is a full coverage look. It's just so, like, so glowy. I have oily skin, but dry patches. I got this Pond's moisturizer the other day from CVS. It's the Rich Hydrating Facial Moisturizer. I've used it twice and my skin is back to normal. It's awesome. We're gonna set our face with Laura Mercier powder, the translucent. One thing I did notice about this foundation, first time I used it, I set my face with Airspun and it looked so cakey. Last time I wore it, I set it with Laura Mercier and it looked normal. So obviously it's not necessarily the foundation. So, but I mean, it's to be expected, honestly. Airspun is like $6 at Walmart, so. I'm not gonna set my lids because I want the most pigment out of my eyeshadows that I'm using today. The bronzer I'm using is my Physician's Formula bronzer. You know, the one that looks real ratchet. I'm gonna spray my face real quick with both the Pixi Skin Treats Vitamin Wake Up Mist and the Urban Decay Quick Fix. My face was just feeling dry, so I drenched myself. When I originally did this look, I exfoliated my lips the night before. So this wouldn't happen, all this chapness going on, because we're going to be wearing a liquid lipstick. I'm going to take my Hoola bronzer and put it in the crease, my crease. Blend out the creases first. because we didn't set the lid. My lids are dry. How does that happen? Can you see that flakiness? That's my skin. I think this eye is better because I'm going in with a lighter hand. I'm gonna try to fix this eye. It's just like so patchy in my inner corner because I went in there too hard. Moral of the story is always go in with a lighter hand, and one way to do that is hold your brush towards the end of the brush instead of closer to the bristles. That's better. Now we're going into Kylie's Diary. We're going to take this color and put it on the very outer corner and keep a light hand with it. Using this brush to blend all the edges. We're gonna use this Urban Decay Heavy Metal Midnight Cowboy Glitter Liner and put it basically everywhere the pink and gold glitter is, and also put it a little above the crease just so when I look forward you can see it, because we're also wearing like pretty big false lashes. So gonna do a wing. Heck? I'm a little broken, I got you. Oh my goodness.
Don't hurt yourself.
Mascara. Lily Lashes in Faux Mink Delara. They're wonderful. Okay, we're done. Thank goodness. Okay, Hoola bronzer. I'm dipping mostly in the orange color. No! I'm supposed to highlight first. Okay, I'm using the Maybelline Master Chrome in Molten Gold. I like doing highlighter first before blush so that I can blend any harsh lines out. Okay, now it's blush time. I'm gonna tight line and line my waterline with some black eyeliner. I'm also gonna put Molten Gold in my inner corner, and I'm gonna put my nose highlight over it, just to make it more white. Ooh, I got this clear mascara, but I use it in my brows, and I feel like it makes my brows look a million times better. I couldn't find a brow gel that wasn't tinted when I went to the drugstore. It doesn't seem like this takes any product out of my brows. It just seems like it spreads the product throughout my brows. Get it? We're gonna do red as the lip color today, and it's like a bright red. When I originally did this look, my dress was black and so was my jacket. I just had it in my head that I wanted to wear a red lipstick. You wouldn't think it goes together, but it really does look good together. But if you don't wanna do a red lip, I would suggest obviously a nude lip, but go for I would say more of like a brownish color, not so much. I mean, you could go for a pink, but I think that's so typical. So I would go for more of like a brown tone, like a tan, sandy kind of color. First, we're gonna go in with this lipstick by that brand, 29. It's this color, so pretty. The name of it is called Call Me a Cab. I'm gonna put this over my lips so it acts like a moisturizer, so the liquid lipstick doesn't dry out my lips so much. The liquid lipstick we're using is by ColourPop. It's pretty old. The name is Creeper. I love this. I have to really concentrate when I do this. It's not easy for me. Fix this right here. I'm going to use this camouflage cream by Dermacolor. It's my favorite thing to use to clean up any like mistakes that I have because it's so pigmented. 5 different colors so that you can mix your own colors together. It's perfect because I can use this when I'm pale like right now and then when I'm really tan in the summer. So I'm literally just putting my brush in here a couple times and then in the lightest one. Voila. And of course, finishing off with my Kat Von D setting spray. So this is the finished look. I hope you like it. I love it. Oh my gosh, I love everything about it. It's very, I guess it's very festive, but when I wore this, I wore it to a holiday party, so. Let me know if there's like a certain look that you want to see. This color is so good. It makes your teeth look so white. Bomb. I love ColourPop. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. You're the best. I love red lips, but I wouldn't normally wear it with this eye look, you know? I love red lips. Did I already say that? These lashes were so difficult. I'm still learning how to apply them correctly. I've watched like a million videos, but one day I'll get it right. And yeah, and I'll be able to do it. But for now, I have to struggle. I don't mind. I appreciate you watching. Hope you learned something new or got some inspo from this video for your next fun makeup look. Love you, and I'll see you in my next one, for sure. Bye.